It's a great big pool that we use to train the astronauts on how to do spacewalks.
I'm in the Neutral Buoyancy Lab at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, and I'm joined by Travis Fitzgerald, who is the Chief Training Officer here. Thank you so much for being here with us today.
Happy to be here.
What is this? It looks like a great big pool, Travis. What's going on here?
That's actually exactly what it is. It's a great big pool that we use to train the astronauts on how to do spacewalks. We'll actually put them inside spacesuits and put them down in the water, and the benefit of the water is it gives them the ability to be neutrally buoyant, hence the name of the building, and allow them to kind of practice what it's like actually being in space and without in the microgravity environment.
Do you want to tell us what neutral buoyancy is? It's not just floating.
Right. So, well, neutral buoyancy in terms of the water is that you're at a point where you don't float and you don't sink.
Okay.
So you stay exactly where you are, and that kind of replicates what it's like in microgravity when you're outside on the space station. That's the best way we have, aside from some of the airplanes we have that do parabolas, but we only get like 10 to 20 seconds of microgravity in that environment. This allows us to do an entire, you know, 6-hour run in the spacesuits to get practice handling the equipment and actually doing the maintenance that's required during a spacewalk.
And the astronauts aren't alone in the pool.
Right. So we've got the two astronauts in the pool in suits, and then they've got a whole host of divers down there with them just in your normal scuba gear that are watching them, making sure they're safe, that are carrying their tools around and handing them tools when they need it. And also for some things like when we broke up where the space station is, the divers will actually say, okay, you're going to translate from this part to that part. You can't actually do that in the pool, so we're going to pick you up and swim you over to this next part and put you on.
How many people does it take to run a dive here?
A lot. It's actually working in the pool and up in the control center and all that, it's probably 40 or 50 people doing this, in addition to all the support personnel that it took to schedule it, to prepare everything, get everything ready to do one run.
Thank you so much for joining us today. This was really fascinating.
Well, I'm happy to be here.
Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.